डियर स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड सत श्री अकाल। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल जपजीन फटक। इन टुडेस वीडियो वी हैव कम अप विद द रिवीजन ऑफ लेसन 1 टू लेसन 4 ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस क्लास 6। बी श्योर टू वॉच दिस वीडियो टू द एंड टू फुली रिहर्स दीज लेसन। सो वी विल नाउ लर्न अबाउट फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स इन लेसन 1। So our first fill in the blank is computer is A or AND dash. So our option is electronic machine, mechanical machine, magnetic machine, or all of the above. So our right answer is computer is A or AND electronic machine. So the second one is computer can do dash. So our option is calculation, accept data and instruction, C storage, and D all of the above. So our right answer is computer can do calculation, accept data and instruction, storage. So our right answer is all of the above. So the third one is computer perform its operation with high dash. So our option is speed, accuracy, quality, or all of the above. So our right answer is computer perform its operation with high speed, accuracy, and quality. So the right answer is all of the above. So the fourth one is in bank computer is used for. So the option is keeping the bank safe, keeping the account record, keeping bank clean, or none of these. So the right answer is in bank computer is used for keeping the account record. So the fifth one is time taken by computer to do a work can be measured in. So the option is minute, hour, millisecond, or days. So the right answer is time taken by computer to do a work can be measured in milliseconds. So the sixth one is in education a computer is used for. So the option is preparing notes, preparing results, preparing reports, all of these. So in education, a computer is used for preparing notes, result, and reports. So the right answer is all of these. So seventh one is which one of these is a limitation of computer. So the option is speed, accuracy, no IQ, and the last one is diligence. So the right answer is no IQ is a limitation of computer. So now we will read about short answer type questions. So our first question is define computer. So a computer is an electronic device designed to work with information. It receives data and instruction from the user in the form of input and follow these instructions. This process of following the instruction on the data is called processing. The result generated after processing is given to the user as a output. So the second question is explain the uses of computer in education field. So the answer is in the field of education, computers are used by student to create notes, draw painting, create project, study through e-content, etc. And teachers use computer to create result, create timetable, create a report card, etc. So our third question is write the name of any three portable computing device. So our answer is name of three portable computing devices are, the first one is smartphone, second one is tablet computer, and third one is laptop computer. So now we will read about long answer type question. So our first question is what are the characteristics of computer. So every feature of computer motivate us to use computer, which is as under. So the first one is speed. The main reason for using computer is the speed of computer. It also complete complex calculation in a very small fraction of a second. The speed of computer work is 1000th of a second, known as millisecond. Second one is accuracy. Accuracy is also an important feature of a computer. Confidence in the accuracy of a computer generated result demonstrate is accuracy. Third one is reliability. Assuring 100% accuracy of the computer generated result, and we do not need to re-evaluate this result demonstrate its reliability. Fourth one is tireless. Computer perform first and last calculation with the same accuracy and speed. The computer does not get tired like a human being while working. As long as the computer work, it give us accurate and precise result. And the fifth one is automation. No assistance is allowed or required while processing the computer. Once the instructions are given, it automatically work till the end and finally provide the result to the user. The sixth one is storage. The storage capacity of the computer is very high. Each computer is equipped with a hard disk device capable of storing all type of data. In it, we can store text, sound, videos, program, animation, etc. as data. So our next question is, define any five application of computer. So area of use of computer means all the area in which computer is used, which are as under. The first one is learning. So in the field of education, computer is used by student for making notes, drawing, creating project, reading through e-content, etc. And computer is used by teachers to create result, timetable, and also used for making report card, etc. The second point is entertainment. Computer is a great means of entertainment. We can listen to song on the computer, watch movies, play games, enjoy unrealistic 3D effect, create new stories and funny scenes in the form of cartoon. This field of multimedia plays an important role in learning methods to play. The third one is sports. Computer is used to enhance the efficiency of the player in the field of sports. The player's daily record is stored in the computer to continue to improve the player's skills. Field game can be played in a closed room using an unrealistic 3D station. The fourth one is hospital. In the hospital, the patient record is kept in the computer. With this, the health care of the patient can be done easily. It is easy to keep track of the patient medication and the effect of each medication on the patient's health. Computers are also used to perform complex tests in the laboratory. The fifth one is bank. A bank is a place where most of the activity in a bank are related to depositing and withdrawing money from the account. All of this work is related to data processing and requires a computer to perform such processing properly. This makes managing all account very easily and efficiently. So the third one question is, what are the limitations of computer? So a computer is capable of doing many things, but it is unable to do many things because it is a machine. Such tasks are called the limitation of the computer, which are as follow. The first one is, a computer cannot make any decision on its own. Second one is, the computer cannot correct any wrong instruction. Third one is, no one can do any work without the instruction of the computer user. Fourth one is, the computer does not have emotions and understanding. The fifth one is, like a human being, he has no knowledge and no experience. So our fourth question is, what do you mean by portable computing devices? Explain any three of them. So all the devices that process data and can be easily moved from one place to another are called portable computing device, which are as under. The first one is smartphone. Smartphone is a portable device which is used to make calls and process data digitally. Smartphone give us camera and more data storage. Smartphones are used for education, business, entertainment, and games. Sixth one is tablet computer. Tablet computer is a thin and portable computer. It is powered with battery and has a touch screen which helps it to be read. In tablet, we can write without keyboard. The third one is palm top computer. Palm top computer is a computer which can be easily operated by placing it on the palm. This type of computer has a small screen and a keyboard. It is not very popular due to its limited uses. So the fifth question is, explain the uses of computer. So computer are used for the following tasks. The first one is, computer are used to perform mathematical calculation. Second one is, we can play games using computer. Third one is, use a computer to draw something. Fourth one is, using a computer we can listen to music and watch movies. The fifth one is, you can use computer to make and print books and newspapers. The sixth one is, we can reserve train, bus and plane ticket with the help of computer. The seventh one is, with the help of computer we can see the schedule of train, buses and planes. The eighth one is, with the help of computer we can find out the weather information of any place before going there. Ninth one is, with the help of computer we can prepare student results, timetable and reports. And the last one is, we can also save important data in the computer for future reference. So we will now learn about fill in the blanks in lesson number 2. The first fill in the blank is, which part of computer system accept input from the user? So the option is, input unit, output unit, control unit or none of these. So the right answer is, input unit, part of computer system accept input from the user. So second one is, which is a part of CPU? So our option is, control unit, memory unit, ALU, yeah, all of these. So our right answer is, control unit, memory unit and ALU is a part of CPU. So the right answer is all of these. The third one is, which memory store permanent data in a computer system? So our option is, primary memory, RAM, secondary memory or all of these. So the right answer is, secondary memory store permanent data in computer system. So the fourth one is, which is a most powerful type of computer? So our option is, mainframe computer, mini computer, microcomputer or supercomputer. So the right answer is, supercomputer is a most powerful type of computer. The fifth one is, which part of computer system gives result as an output to the user? So the option is, memory, input unit, control unit and the last one is, output unit. So the right answer is, output unit, part of computer system gives result as an output to the user. So now we will learn about full form. So ALU, the full form of ALU is arithmetic logic unit, CPU, and its full form is central processing unit, LCD, and its full form is liquid crystal display. RAM, and RAM full form is random access memory. ROM, and its full form is read-only memory. CU, full form is control unit. And seventh one is MU. MU full form is memory unit. And the last one is IPO. IPO full form is input processing and output. So now we will learn about very short answer type question. So our first question is, write the name of part of CPU. So the answer is, the central processing unit section of a computer system is divided into three sections. The first one is memory unit, the second one is control unit, and the third one is arithmetic and logic unit. So our second question is, what are the type of memory? So there are two type of computer memory. The first one is primary memory and the second one is secondary memory. So our third question is, what are the secondary storage devices? So secondary storage device store all the data that is not currently in the computer primary storage or main memory. It is the memory of a computer system that does not allow CPU to have direct access. It is used to store data for a long time and the data stored in it is not lost even in case of power failure. It is also called non-volatile memory. It's not too expensive. It has high storage capacity it can be easily moved from one place to another. So our fourth question is, what is the function of ALU? So this unit does arithmetic and logical work. ALU is also called the building block of the central processing unit of a computer system, because this block follow instruction. In a digital computer, most of the work is done logically and involves a lot of calculation to be processed. This part of the computer system is built inside the microprocessor. So our fifth question is, what is a microcomputer? So these computers were so small that they could easily be placed on a desk. They are also called computer on a chip. These computers do about 1 million calculations per second. These computers are used in small offices, schools, small businesses, and other work areas. So our fifth question is, what are the different categories of computer? So there are four types of computer based on speed, memory, processing capacity, and storage capacity. The first one is microcomputer, second one is mini computer, third one is mainframe computer, and the fourth one is supercomputer. So now we will learn about long answer type question. So our first question is, what do you mean by block diagram of computer? Define its component. So a block diagram of a computer refers to the interconnected structure of all parts of a computer. We can see this structure as a graphic presentation. So parts of central processing unit are, the first one is memory unit. So memory unit is the part of computer system where data and instruction are kept for processing. Although this CPU has a very close relationship with, but in fact it is different from it. There are many types of memory. Each type of memory does a different job. They vary in size, storage capacity, mode of operation, and speed. The second part of central processing unit is control unit. The control unit is also called the control system, the control central controller, or the brain of the computer. It directs the various components of a computer system, such as receiving input, instructing the storage of data for processing, and producing result. It reads the instruction in a program one by one, translates them, and control other part of the computer system in a series. So third part of the CPU is arithmetic and logic unit. This unit perform arithmetic and logical operation, a function. ALU is also called the building block of the central processing unit of a computer system, because this block follow instruction. In a digital computer, most of the work is done logically and involve a lot of calculation to be processed. So the block diagram of CPU parts is as given below. So our next question, number second, is how computer works. Explain each term in detail. So the process of processing in a computer is called computer processing cycle. Computer processing can be represented in three different parts. The first one is input. This part of computer processing cycle is related to receiving data and instruction by computer. In a computer system, all instruction are processed in the form of electrical signal. Such a change is made by the input device. And the second one is processing. Applying the input instruction to the given data is called processing. This is the main task performed by a computer. There is a lot of mathematical and logical work done during processing. This is done through a microprocessor attached to the computer. The third one is output. The result generated after the processing is completed is given to the user through the output unit. So devices used for output purposes convert the result from an electrical signal to a human understandable type. So we will now learn about fill in the blanks in lesson number 3. So the first one is screen appeared after login of a computer is called start menu, desktop, taskbar, or none of these. So The right answer is a screen appeared after login of a computer is called desktop. Second one is all the deleted files go to. So the option is my computer network, recycle bin, or all of above. So the right answer is all the deleted files go to recycle bin. The third one is which part of window remains visible all the time when we use other application. So the option is recycle bin, desktop, taskbar, and none of these. So taskbar part of the window remain visible all the time when we use other applications. So the fourth one is which one is an example of operating system. So our option is Windows, Android, DOS, or all of these. So the right answer is all of these is an example of operating system. So the fifth one is to open a file we can double click on. So the option is file itself, shortcut of file, both A and B, or none of these. So the right answer is to open a file we can double click on file itself or shortcut of file. So the right answer is both A and B. So now we will read about short answer type question. So our first question is write the name of any three window application. So the name of the three window application are as follow. The first one is Notepad, second one is WordPad, third one is Paint, and the fourth one is Calculator. So our second question is write the name of any three icons. So the name of three icons are as follow. The first one is My Computer, the second one is Network, third one is Recycle Bin, and the fourth one is User Files. Third question is write the name of component of a desktop. So the name of a component of a desktop are icon, the second one is shortcut, third one is wallpaper, and the fourth one is taskbar. So our fourth question is what is desktop. The first screen that appears after the login process is complete is called the desktop, also called the basic controller of the computer. With the help of desktop screen, any application or program can be run or any other need can be done. So now we will read about long answer type question. So the first question is what is operating system? Explain different type of operating system. The operating system provides an interface between the computer user and the computer hardware and makes the computer hardware usable by controlling all the internal function of the computer. All the devices such as mobile phone, tablet, iPad also use the operating system, and through it the necessary tasks are performed. The main example of operating systems are Windows, Macintosh, Linux, DOS, Android, Symbian, etc. So the first one type of operating system is Windows. The Windows operating system is developed by Microsoft and provides a graphical user interface that can be easily accessed with the mouse. Whenever we click on any program in the Windows operating system, the program opens in a separate frame that looks like a window, hence the name window. So key example of Windows operating system are Windows XP, Windows 95, Windows 98, Windows NT, Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, etc. So second type of operating system is DOS. The full name of DOS is Disk Operating System. DOS is also developed by Microsoft. The DOS operating system provides a character user interface for working on computer system. It is the oldest operating system that was used when computer were not very powerful. These operating systems are also capable of running on low memory and slow hardware and are very difficult to use. The third one is Android. The Android operating system is a mobile-based operating system developed by Google. The Android operating system is mostly used in touchscreen devices like mobile phone and tablet. The Android operating system provides us with a finger operator interface. The main task of which include scaling, scrolling, and clicking the screen view. The Android operating system is now used in television core and wristwatches. So our second question is, what is taskbar? Explain the function of its parts. The taskbar is part of the operating system and is located at the bottom of the computer screen. The taskbar allows us to run any program using the start button, and this bar is always visible when using any program. The area to the right of the taskbar is called the notification area, and we use it to see the time and date and the program running on the previous screens. So various taskbar tasks are: first one is start button. Using the start button, we can start any application or program. This is the first button on the left side of the taskbar. Second one is quick launch bar. This section allows us to run any program without opening the start button. The third one is system tray. It is located on the right side of the taskbar, and it has a small icon which helps us to easily access system functions like fax, printer, modem, voice, etc. The fourth one is notification area. This section gives us messages about the status of various computer devices. So the fifth one is clock. The clock appears on the right side of the taskbar, where we can view and change the current date and time. The sixth one is active program. All running programs are displayed in this part of the taskbar. So our third question is, what do you mean by icon? Explain any three desktop icons. So the small picture that appear on the desktop screen are called icon. Each icon appears as a button which is used to access any folder, file, or program by double clicking with the mouse. So the first desktop icon is my computer. This icon is used to access all the devices in the computer system like hard disk drive and other devices. And the second one is network. This icon is used to access any part of the network. This button is used when a local area network is created and our computer is connected to it. And the third one is recycle bin. This icon is used to store all deleted files, folder, icon, etc. Recycle bin are like dustbin kept in houses in which garbage, etc. is kept. So our fourth question is, explain the different option of shutting down a computer system. So various options for shutting down the computer system are explained as under. The first one is sleep mode. This option is used when we do not want to use the computer for some time. In this case, the monitor or LCD is turned off and the internal data of the computer is saved. Second one is shutdown. This option is used when all our work is done and we want to shut down the computer. Third one is log off. Each computer has more than one user account, and the log off option is used to log in from one user account to another. Fourth one is restart. This option is used when a new program is installed in the computer or any changes are made in the system. So we will now learn about fill in the blanks in lesson number 4. So the first fill in the blank is, the dash bar is present at the top of the paint window. The option is title bar, status bar, scroll bar, or task bar. So the right answer is the title bar is present at the top of the paint window. So our second fill in the blank is, dash toolbar present in the title bar by default. Its position can be changed either to below or above the ribbon. So the option is quick access to a bar, status bar, scroll bar, or all of these. So the right answer is quick access toolbar present in the title bar by default. Its position can be changed either to below or above the ribbon. The third one is, the first on the left of the menu bar is the dash button. So the option is paint, help, close, or minimize. So the right answer is the first on the left of the menu bar is the paint button. So the fourth fill in the blank is scroll bar is used to move the screen. It is of dash types. So the option is 2, 3, 4 or 5. So the right answer is scroll bar is used to move the screen. It is of two types. With the help of dash option, we can save a copy of picture with another. So the option is save as, open, new or exit. So the right answer is with the help of save as option, we can save a copy of picture with another. So now we will learn about write the shortcut keys for the following. So the first one is to create a new file, the shortcut is Ctrl plus N. To open an existing file, the shortcut key is Ctrl plus O. To save a file, the shortcut key is Ctrl plus S. To print a file, Ctrl plus P, shortcut key is used. To undo, Ctrl plus Z, shortcut key is used. Redo or repeat, the shortcut key is Ctrl plus Y. So now we will read about short answer type question. So our first question is, what is Paint? MS Paint is a drawing tool used for drawing or drawing pictures. A file created in Paint is also called a bitmap file. The extension of the file saved in Paint is .bmp. How to start the MS Paint? The steps to get started with MS Paint are as follow. Click the Start button. Click on All Program. Click on the Accessory option. Then click on the Paint option. So our third question is, write the name of part of Windows or Paint. So the window, the Paint window has several sections. The name of the main component are as follow. First one is title bar. Second one is quick access toolbar. Third one is tabs and ribbons. Fourth one is scroll bar. Fifth one is work area or drawing area. Sixth one is status bar. And seventh one is zoom slider. The fourth question is, what is work area? The work area is also called the drawing area. This is the space between the paint that is used to make the picture. In other words, work area are places where beautiful and attractive drawing can be made. The fifth question is, explain the use of save command. Using the save command, we can save a picture or painting made in MS Paint. To save an image created in MS Paint, use the Save option from the File menu or the Ctrl plus S shortcut key is to be used. So sixth question is, what are the type of scroll bar? The scroll bar is used to slide the screen. There are two types. First one is horizontal scroll bar and the second one is vertical scroll bar. So now we will read about long answer type question. The first question is, what is quick access toolbar? Explain its parts. Quick access toolbar is a toolbar that allows us to quickly access some commonly used command. This one is already present in the title bar. We can add or remove command as needed in this toolbar. The quick access toolbar can be placed below or above the ribbon. The second question is, define home tab ribbon. The Home tab ribbon is the main ribbon of Paint. This ribbon is located at the bottom of the title bar. Most of the commands used in Paint are present in this ribbon. All the tools, shape, color palette, and many more commands are present in this ribbon. We need the Home tab to do all kind of work in Paint. There is also the option to minimize the Home tab. If we select this option, the Home tab ribbon stops appearing on the screen. It appears again when we click on the Home tab. So student, if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you get notification of more video like this. Thank you.